new beginning. It is a new month. In the mighty name of Jesus, a new month is a new beginning. It is, we are starting a new fresh. All has gone, new has come. We want to thank you, God, that you are God, my Father. Because you are God, all has gone, new has come. Therefore, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to bless your name, to give you all the glory, because all has gone and new has come. As we are beginning the new month, we want to appreciate you for this new month, God. My Father, in the name of Jesus, I appreciate this month. I thank you, Lord, for the month of August. I thank you the rest of the month that is coming. We give all the glory, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, we honor you. I glorify your name, Jesus. I thank you, my God and my Father, in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I destroy anything programmed in this month. Any power of darkness programmed in this month, I destroy them. I come against the powers that is living in this month. The spirit of death and hell, I curse you. The spirit of accident, I curse you. The spirit of poverty, I curse you. Any power, anything programmed in this month, I take the authority by the power and the blood of Jesus to curse them and command them to obey the word of God in the name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, my Father, I commit this month to you, Lord. I lift your name up, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father. Oh, yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus. Lord, I commit this month into your hand, God. I dedicate this month into your hand, God. I praise your name. I pray, God Almighty, receive this month, God, in the name of Jesus. Because you are the one who has made this month. You have said we will rejoice and be glad in it. No power, no treachery, no sorrow, by the power and the blood of Jesus. No sickness, no pain. I destroy anything programmed in this month. This month will be the month of praise and worship, the month of thanks and giving, the month of that we will be grand, the month that we will be happy and rejoice, the month of financial breakthrough in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, we have been your people have been struggling so much. Now is the new things that's coming. All is gone. We will celebrate and be glad in it. We give God glory. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus. All these things that we have been struggling is gone. Is dead. Now we are standing in new things. As the new month is beginning, God, let everything new begin. Let our finances begin new. Let our business begin new. Let our jobs begin new. Everything has come new. All has gone. All has gone and new has come. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, my Father. God, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. Yes, Lord, my Father. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, my God, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus. I want to thank you, Lord. I want to bless your name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory be the name of Jesus, Son of the living God. We thank you. We bless your name. We give you all the glory. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My Father and my God, I want to thank you. I want to bless you. I want to give you all the glory. O Rabba Shantoro Rabba Kuria. Reba Baba Shitoro Rabba Kuria. Ramba Baba Shantoro Rabba Kuraba. Ramba Baba Shantoro Rabba Kuraba. Oh, yes, Lord, my Father. Yes, Lord, my God. Ora baba bashantoro raba kuraba. Ora baba bashantara raba kuraba. Ora baba bashitara raba kuraba. Ora baba bashantoro raba kuraba. Ora baba bashantara raba kuria. Rekere raba kuraba baba shanto. Yes, Lord, my Father. In the name of Jesus, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to worship you. I honor you, Jesus. You are a great God. You are a marvelous God. As we worship you, Lord, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I want to thank you, Jehovah. I bless your name. I welcome this month. It's a month that new things has come, all has gone. when if you have been struggling the rest of the month, now begin to thank God and worship Him and say thank you. The month, those months has gone and new month has come. You have to expect the good things to come to you. Prophesize to yourself. Say, I have been suffering enough. Now today, as we begin this month, we will be celebrating. Hallelujah. Am I right? Yes. No. I'm wrong. Today is 31st. Sorry for that. Because I said I was sleeping. And I wake up. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you for reminding me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You are so good. We can make mistakes. Because I didn't sleep well. And I wake up mixed up. So you see, I'm thinking that today is that it's fast. It's not fast. So I thank God that today is that the fast, not fast. So I thank God that whole things is dying as this month is dying, as this month is ending and new things is coming. As we are celebrating at the end of this month, we thank God. Thank you, Father. Holy Spirit, I love you. Thank you for reminding me, saying, Christine, what are you doing? We are still 31st. Yes, I thank you. I thank you for the whole things is gone, new things has come. In the name of Jesus, still my message is the same. So I want to thank God and I appreciate God in the mighty name of Jesus. Even people of Periscope, you can't remind me. You also thank God that the Holy Spirit is good. You can't make mistakes. When you make the spirit, they will collect you until you are low, you are roast. Correct? Sometimes even the scripture, I type exactly the scripture, what it is, and I found that instead of putting 3, maybe I put 2. When you are typing, sometimes you can type error, but the scripture is the message is the same, but typing can be error. Then the Holy Spirit will say, hello, something is not right. Well, we thank the Holy Spirit. God, I appreciate you so much, God. I thank the Holy Spirit that you are there for us. Oh, God, I thank you, Lord, as we are coming for the end of this month, as this month is dying. We thank you. Let everything die with the month of this month. Every problem, every sickness, every disease, let it die in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, as we are going to begin new month, my Lord, and we would appreciate you and thank you, Father, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. My God, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we lift up your name, Jesus. We thank you, my God. We appreciate you and honor you. We glorify your name. You are a wonderful God, wonderful Father. I lift your name up, God. I thank you, Jehovah. Oh, hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I want to thank God and I give God thanks. So anything that has been against you, any problem that you have faced in the month of anger, the month of July, you can open your mouth and say, let it die as the month is dying. Let it end as the month is ending. As you are ending this month, let every problem, anything that is working against you, let it end in the name of Jesus. This marriage you have been fighting, let it end with this month in the mighty name of Jesus. Let every storm, everything you have been struggling, let it end as this month is ending in the mighty name of Jesus. Let it end in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, all of what you have been going through the rest of the month, from the month of January, February, March, April, May, June, July, let it die with this month as the month is gone. In the mind, time has gone, everything has changed. So let everything change in your life in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, my Father. As you begin a new month, you will jump to the month and celebrate and give God thanks and say, God, thank you for the new month. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. We appreciate you in the mighty name of Jesus. We will not have overnight crossover. To the new month, but we are praying that God will deliver you in Jesus' name. It shall be well with you in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, we thank God. We give God glory. We bless Him. We give honor. We appreciate Him. You have to take time. tonight, midnight. I wouldn't have prayer midnight, but you have to wake up midnight. It is private. It's time for you to stand up midnight and welcome the month of August. You appreciate it and let everything that has been working against you to die as this month is dying. Let everything that you are expecting, the new things that you are expecting, let it come to pass in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Father. I'm going to read from the book of 1 Corinthians, 2 Corinthians 7, hallelujah, 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17. 2 Corinthians 5 verse 17. The Bible says, therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come, the whole has gone, the new is here. So if anyone is in Christ, the Bible says, therefore, if anyone in Christ, the new creation has come, the whole has gone. And this is NIV. This is NIV. And let me see King James what it says. King James says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. All you are in Christ. Everything has gone. Everything, all things has gone, and the new things has come. So forget about the fight you have been going through. Forget about what you have been going through. Forget about everything that has been working against you. All those old things have gone, and the new things has come. God is going to make a new things to you to start working for you again in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you for the new things that has come. Whole things has gone and new things has come because we are in Christ and we believe your word, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to honor you, God. I want to thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, my Lord and my Savior, I thank you, Jesus. I give you all the glory. I honor you, Lord. Loving Father, I appreciate you. I give you all the glory, Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. Yes, Lord, I appreciate your name. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, I pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to read another scripture from the book of Isaiah. The book of Isaiah 43, verse 18 to 19. The book of Isaiah 43. The book of Isaiah 43, verse 18 to 19. The Bible says, remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. Remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. Do you not preserve it? I will make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. That is how you will make the new beginning agreement. Because God has said, hallelujah, praise be the name of Jesus. Yes, God, you are wonderful. God, you have said, you will make new things. That is how you make agreement. You make agreement with the man. Because God has said, he's going to make new things. God has said, he's going to make new things. He said, remember not the former things, nor consider the things of old. Behold, I am doing a new thing. Now it springs forth. Do you not preserve it? I will make a way in the wilderness and leave us in the desert. The Lord is going to make a way in the wilderness and deliver us in the desert. So deliver us in the desert. Deliver us in the wilderness and in the desert. Any desert in your life, in the mighty name of Jesus, that desert, you know, desert is a place where nothing can grow. It's only rocks. Maybe you are in that situation. That's why you have to make agreement. You have to pray that God, as I'm beginning this month, the month of August, as this month is dying, and I'm going to the month of August, I am making a covenant. Because you have promised, you will flow a river. You will make a river in the desert. Make a river start flowing in my desert. Let make the river start flowing in your finances. Let the river start flowing in your marriage. Let the river start flowing in your business, in your job, in your children, in the mighty name of Jesus. Where there is no way, that God will create a way for you. In the name of Jesus Christ. My God and my Father, I want to lift your name up. I want to thank you because you are a God who makes a way where it seems to be no way. You are a God who will make a way in the wilderness and leave us in the desert. You are a God. Holy things has gone and new has come. In the mighty name of Jesus. Remember not the former things. The Bible says, do not remember all former things. Do not remember what your enemy has done to you. Don't remember. It has gone. They were expecting you to die, but you are alive. They were expecting you to suffer, to be in prison, but you are coming out. There are some people who were supposed to be in prison right now, but by the grace of God, God has favored them, they are out of the prison. There are some people, the enemy planned to kill them. By the grace of God, they are alive. So don't remember those things. It's gone. We are going to consider new things. We are going to look at the new things. We want to thank him. We have to celebrate and grab and give him honor and appreciate him and thank him. And say, God, thank you that all things has gone. I will not remember them. Don't remember them. I'm not going to remember what people have done to you, disgrace you, disrespect you, cursing you, doing evil and wicked. Let it go. Let it go in the name of Jesus. Let everything go. And forgive your friends, forgive your enemies, forgive anybody that has been working against you. Let it go. You do not have to remember the whole things. You do not have to remember what the enemy has done to you. Just move on with your life. And you have to stop him. You make agreement. You say, my God, as I come to you this month, the new beginning, it is coming to me. I am coming to you in the mighty name of Jesus. Everything that I've lost, I claim them. Everything that the enemy has done to me, I claim them. I claim them and I forgot everything that he has done to me. And now I need you to pay me back in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, you've been wasting time. You have been wasting the enemy stealing your time. But it is a new thing. New beginning is coming. You start with the new ideas. New ideas is coming in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. I want to thank you, God. I want to appreciate you, God. I give you all the glory, my Father. My Father and my God, in the name of Jesus, I thank you, Lord. I thank you for the new ways. God, when God says, I will make a way in the wilderness and leave us in the desert, God has not changed. He will do it because he has promised. I am going to pray for you. I have so much prayers. I am going to pray these prayers and I pray that God will deliver you. We will destroy every hidden idol and worshiping of ancestors that bring with the blood of Jesus. Anything that is working against you as you begin the new month, as you begin the new life, the new beginning. So we are going to destroy every hidden idols, anything your forefathers worshipped that is hindering you, that you cannot receive the blessings of God. As you begin this new month, you will move on with the new things. You have to stop everything the enemy or your forefather did, anything that would hinder you, anything that would work against you, that you will stop them because you are going to make agreement with the new month that is coming. Yes, I pray that every hidden idols worshipped by your forefathers, I bring the blood of Jesus against you today. Today, in the name of Jesus. Every hidden idols worshipped by your forefathers, your ancestors, your ancients. I bring the judgment of God with the blood of Jesus against you today in the name of Jesus. Image of idols of your ancestors, forming you and your children. I am asking them right now to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, my Father. God, my Father, I want to thank you, Lord. I want to praise your name. I pray every images of the idols of your forefathers, of your ancestors, and your children, I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. There are some idols that has been working against your life. As you come to a new month, as you come to a new beginning, you command those idols. You know there's some idols still are working against you and you have no ideas. The image of the idols of your ancestors, it is not you, but the image of your forefathers that are crying against you. As you are jumping to a new month, as this month is ending, let those images that are crying against you, let them catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. You will go new month with the new things. Everything that has been working against you, let them die in the name of Jesus. I take the cross of Jesus Christ as a digger, and I dig into the wall of evil secret of your ancestors in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Take the cross of Jesus and dig the wall of evil secrets of our ancestors and let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You know the digger, the thing that people used to dig, and you dig the wall of every secret of your ancestors. Dig it and destroy it in Jesus' name. Wherever they are hiding, every secret of your ancestors, every secret of your generational that is working against you, dig it and destroy it in the name of Jesus. Let the digger dig it and remove it and destroy them and expose them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You know, when you expose those secrets of your forefathers, they will not have power over your life in the mighty name of Jesus. You go with the Spirit of God in a spiritual realm and you dig it and you bring it up and you destroy it, you set it fire in the name of Jesus. Every satanic door preventing you access to the evil secret of ancestors, scattered by thunder in the name of Jesus. Every satanic door preventing you access to the evil. Every satanic door preventing your access to the evil secret of ancestors, scattered by thunder in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Abominational beast of your ancestors and appearing in a dream, I command them to catch fire, to burn to ashes in Jesus' name. Wicked and destruction characteristic of your ancestors, idols manifesting in your life, I cast them in the name of Jesus Christ. I command them to be destroyed in Jesus' name. Many of you, many people, they are affected. They are being followed by ancestors, by generational curses, by your bloodline. That's why as we begin new month, as we begin, this month is going to die, let those power to die with the month. Let them leave you. That's why I'm praying that the ancestors, powers of ancestors, powers of the generational, powers of the curses, all these wicked and destructive characteristic of your ancestors, let them be destroyed and be rendered powerless in the name of Jesus. Every characteristic of your ancestors, all the wicked that they did, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you. My God and my Father, we give you all the glory. We honor you, Lord. I thank you, my God. I glorify your name, Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Rapa Papa Shitara Rabakuria, Priam Baba Pashotoro Rabakuria, Rapa Papa Shantoro Rabakuria. Yes, Lord, my Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, God Almighty, King of Glory, King of Kings. Lord, I want to appreciate your name. I want to thank you, Father. I worship you, God. I honor you, Jehovah. You are a mighty God. You are a wonderful God. My God and my Father, I bless your name. I give you the glory, Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus, my God and my Father. I honor you, Jesus. Glorious God, I thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Any ancestral place of most dark where your ancestors sought refuge, I break it, and you set yourself free. Break it and you will be free in Jesus' name. Every sacred, the place of the most dark where your ancestors sought refuge, I command that place to be break. I break it and they destroy it. I command them to catch fire and you will be free in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Every shadow of all wicked created by the sacred place of the most dark of your ancestors over your life, scattered by thunder in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, my Father. Yes, Jesus. My God, I want to thank you. Every transaction with the dark kingdom where your life or your destiny was used as a collector be canceled and be withdrawn. Your name and by the blood of Jesus. Your marriage, your founders, your stars, your glory and your children, your destiny and your wealth shall not be used as a correctable in the name of Jesus Christ. I am committing your family, your children, your founders, your marriage, your glory, your destiny, and your wealth will not be used by the enemy, by the ancestors, by the devil this month in the mighty name of Jesus. You will not be used. You will not be used. I address everyone with the blood of Jesus. I am addressing every powers of darkness that will use your children, will use your husband, will use your wife, will use your wealth, will use your destiny to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. You will not be used. When the enemy is planning to use you, to use your children, to use you to destroy your life, I am coming against them and I bind them and I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Yes, my God. You are making agreement with this month as the month is beginning, as this month is dying and the new month is coming. You are making agreement that you will not be used by the devil. Your child will not be used by the devil. Your wealth will not be used by the devil. Your money will not be used by the devil. Don't give your money to your devil, to the devil. That's why you have to say, as I make agreement that this month I will not give my money to the devil. The devil will not use my money. The devil can use your money in so many ways. If you get a banja, that is the devil is taking your money by force, by all means. Yeah. If sickness comes or something happen which will take money quickly, that is the work of the devil. That's why you have to make a covenant. You have to make agreement. You declare, you say, this month, I will not give my money to any work of the devil. I will not fund the devil anything that he will use me to give him money. The devil is not going to use me to have argument with anybody this month in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. As this month is ending, let it end with all evil that the enemy is planning against me and my family and my children in Jesus' name. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank God that it's a new beginning is coming. That all these things must go. Any ancestral covenant made by your ancestors affecting your life, break by the blood of Jesus. I break them by the blood of Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus. Wicked colleagues of your ancestors working hard to initiate you. You know there are some wicked colleagues, wicked friends of your forefathers. They are friends that are watching the children. They are friends of your forefathers. They are watching you, how you are doing, so they will come to initiate you. They will say, your father was doing this, and you are a child, you are his child. Why don't you follow your father's pattern or your forefather's pattern? You people, you are changing patterns. Those are the friends, colleagues. They are claiming you. They want to initiate you. Let those colleagues and their ways be destroyed and burned to ashes in Jesus' name. Jesus, new things has come, all has gone. So those people have gone. Let them go. Let them go completely from your life. Ancestors, generational curses, let them leave you and go. As this man is dying, let them die with this man and leave you in the name of Jesus. Move forward. Move forward by fire. Move forward by thunder in the mighty name of Jesus. Let the blessings of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob fall upon you this new month as it's coming in the mighty name of Jesus. All what the ancestors, generational curses, witchcraft, whatever they are planning to do, as the new month is beginning, let them be destroyed and be bound in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I want to thank you, my God. Father, I pray every tool of power, demonic weapons, passed down by your ancestors, looking for you to take over, I command them to catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus Christ. Every tool of power, demonic weapons passed down by your ancestors, looking for you to take over, catch fire. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes in the name of Jesus. Let them catch fire and burn to ashes in the mighty name of Jesus. Every evil accommodation, evil thrones, position and authority of your ancestors, I command them to receive fire. To receive fire and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. In the cruel and wicked sacrifice offered by your ancestors, now speaking against you, I command them to die by the blood of Jesus in the mighty name of Jesus. Any curses for the cheated abuse or oppression against you, against your family line, mass of God wipe them away. Let the mass of God wipe them away. Any curse from the cheated, abused or oppressed against your family line, mass of God, wipe them away, wipe them away, wipe them away in the name of Jesus. I pray that God will have mercy. Let the mass of God to wipe every ancestors. Let the mass of God, to wipe every curses and cheated that has been happening in your family line in the mighty name of Jesus. Remember, the old has gone, the new has come. Therefore, I destroy everything that is working against you, that is standing against you, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you, my God, my Father and my God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, my Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that you receive power to convert failure, destiny for your life to outstanding success, in the name of Jesus. I pray that you will receive power to convert failures, destiny for your new life. You will receive power to convert failures, destined for your life to outstanding success. If you've been a failure, you have been failing, now I prophesy to you, by the power in the blood of Jesus, you will succeed. You will convert that failure to successful. That failure, you will convert it to successful. Failure is not dead. Failure, you cannot stay there. You will wake up. You will stand up. If you fell on the ground, you are not staying there. You will wake up and start moving. Maybe you failed those other months, but this month, you are not going to fail. In the mighty name of Jesus, you will succeed. You will be successful. Anything you are touching, it will be successful. Your job, it will be successful. Your business will be successful. Everything you are going to do is going to be successful in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, I thank God for your life. In the name of Jesus Christ, I thank you. You've been struggling so much, but the new month is coming. The new beginning is coming. You will be successful. You will be successful in the mighty name of Jesus. I hear successful. You are going to be successful. You are going to be successful. You are going to succeed. Don't give up. Don't be discouraged. Don't be like people who are abusing others. You will not abuse anybody. You will do your best in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord Almighty will help you and deliver you and move you forward. Never forget what has passed. Forget what has happened. Forget your failure. Forget them because it's new things has come. The Bible says You are a new creature. All has gone. All has gone. You are a new creation. All has gone. New has come. Failure is not a denial. When you fail, it doesn't mean that you will never rest up and you will never move forward. I pray that God will make you to move forward. Maybe you feel like you have lost hope, you have nothing, but all is gone. New has come. Just make a covenant. Make an agreement with the new man that is coming. Say, everything that has been working against me, as this man is dying, let them die with this man in the mighty name of Jesus. And as a new man is coming, let new begin with me. You have to start a new beginning. You have to go to the bathroom and wash yourself and bathe yourself and say, everything that has been working me, I wash myself and I declare me, I wash everything. I wash my house. I wash everything. Let it go in the name of Jesus Christ. You wash yourself with the blood of Jesus. You say bye-bye to them this month. Bye-bye and let it go. Any storm, anything you have faced, let it go as this month is going. That's how you come against the enemy. And you prophesy good things to come for the next month and the other month coming. You are expecting miracles, financial breakthrough, jobs, good things, wives, husbands, children. Those people are looking for the fruit of the womb. They will conceive, and they will by the next year they will have their kids. You pray that God, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Lord, as I come before you, I need a miracle. I need supernatural miracle in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. The Lord will provide miracle for you. Remember, He will make a wilderness in the liver in the desert. So God is a God of impossibility. God is a God of impossibility. God, there is nothing impossible to God. God is an impossibility. If He can make livers on the wilderness, in the desert, what about you? He will create something which looks impossible. He will create it and He will have it and you will receive it. Just keep on praying and trust God and thank Him and say, God, thank you that I am ending this month, and let treachery and anything that is programmed in this month, as it is dying, let them die with the month in Jesus' name. Yes, Lord, I thank God and I bless Him. I give Him the glory. Oh, my God, I thank you, Jesus. Every power assigned to lead you ancestral, assigned to lead you astray, beyond your repentance, you are a liar. They are a liar. The powers that as assigned to lead you to astray, I pray that they will be destroyed in the name of Jesus. You know, there's powers that have been assigned to make you to be astray, to lose your direction, to lose your repentance, that you never repentant. You never repent to God. There are some powers the enemy is programming. The enemy is working. When the enemy is marked you, they work so hard to see that nothing is going to work for you. But tell them, you are a liar. You are completely a liar. Die in the name of Jesus. Reject every satanic alternatives for your life, your destiny, your marriage, your job. Refuse it in the name of Jesus. Hidden family secret opposing your acceleration, be exposed. You know, some people, they are going through family hidden secret. The family, they are so hard for you. They don't want you to marry this man or to marry this woman. The family are against everything you are doing. They want to control you. They want you to do what they want. They don't know that your Jesus is different from their Jesus. They don't know that you have democracy. They don't know you have freedom. They don't know that you have prayed. God has given you this man or this woman. Now they are interfering with their idols, with their satanic idols. Now they are opposing you. They are blocking you. They are chanting against you. They are so against you. As this man is going to die, let those family secret are opposing you to die with them in the name of Jesus. Every family that people, some people are going through family burden. Family are really against on your neck. Your parents have refused that they don't want to see this man in your home. They don't want to see this girl. They are opposing you. Your own family, they don't want. They are against what you are doing. Let Jesus Christ, the cross of Jesus Christ, visit them. Let the Holy Spirit visit them. Let them be visited by the power of God so that they can leave you in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Mysterious or one time redeemed in your family line. By the power in the blood of Jesus Christ, I command them to die. Mysterious, untimely dead. They are mysterious, untimely dead people. They die premature. I had a testimony yesterday. This sister, her husband was crushed, died in the crash. So, and the airplane crash. And he was so young. He was only 35 years. And the couple was so young. That is untimely dead. That is untimely dead. It's not good dead. Untimely dead, when somebody die like that young, it's untimely dead. That's what we call it, untimely dead. Therefore, as this month is beginning, as it is ending, let them die without problem. We destroy untimely dead, mysterious untimely dead. Mysterious untimely dead. Maybe your family are dying, nobody reach 50, people are dying in your family. So I destroy that untimely dead in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I pray that God, you are God. I destroy and bind out mysterious dead. Let them be destroyed and let them get out of your family in the mighty name of Jesus. Mysterious of poverty in your family line. You are a liar. I command you to die. Mysterious poverty. One of my brother was talking to me last night. That's why even I didn't sleep well. He was telling me that his own brother has a big business in one of African country. Now, suddenly, he was, many people were, it's like a tourist hotel and business. He was doing very well, thousands, and he was making a lot of money. So something happened suddenly, and then the people they moved to another country. Then something happened that his business went down. In 1 month, everything, he lost everything in 1 month. Everything, like Job. Job lost his children one day, lost everything. So this man, he lost all money, everything in 1 month. So he is right now at the age of 50, is now square one. He has gone back to square one, nothing. That is mysterious poverty. Therefore, you don't expect that any mysterious poverty in your bloodline, in your family line, let them die. Any mysterious poverty that is waiting to you to work, to have money, to have business, to have everything, then it comes to take it away, and then you remain in poverty. As you begin this month, as this month is dying, let them die with them in Jesus' name. Mysterious poverty, hear the word of God. I curse you from the root. I bind you, I destroy you in Jesus' name. If this brother had known this prayer, his wealthy could not go like this. But because, and it's a brother, he goes to church, but he didn't know. And something has happened, all those thousands, all is what he has is he has reduced to nothing. Nothing. So he's planning to go back to his country and start afresh from zero. That is mysterious poverty. That's why I was praying for you, poverty, that if you are being affected, if you are one of the victims of poverty, I ask you to call me. I will pray for you. Call our numbers. I know what is the problem you are facing. If you can follow my videos, you will see what I'm talking about. You cannot be a rector and you are living in a rental house. You cannot be a bank manager and still you are living in a poverty level. You cannot be in this country, the country of opportunity, and you are still under heavy bondage. You are living in poverty. That is a lie. So that is mysterious poverty is following you. Call me. Our number is 647-608-5207. This is what God is saying, that if you call me, I would attack that poverty and they will go. You will be set free. You cannot live such a life. That's a lie. When you don't know, you don't know. But now you know. because there is power called mysterious poverty that they are waiting for you, and you cannot have money. You can't enjoy your finances. You cannot be happy. You are not happy. The powers of your father's house, the powers of your mother's house are crying against you. That's why I'm attacking those ancestral powers. That's why I'm attacking those generational curses. Because as you are coming the new month, let those powers leave you. Let them leave you and you go forward in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Evil powers demanding your worship or sacrifice, receive the blood of Jesus and burn to ashes in Jesus' name. There are evil powers demanding for your sacrifice, demanding for your worshiping. When you want to sacrifice to God, when you want to give to God, these powers, they come and oppose you, they deny you, and they say no. They hold you from giving. And when they hold you, they infect you with poverty or with sickness, with something else. They bless it. They can hold your finances. They can hold your worshiping. They can hold your sacrifice. You want to sacrifice to God time, even time to come to church. They will hold you. They will take it. Now you don't have time to come to church. And then after getting you, they will weaken your prayer. They will take away your prayer. After taking your prayer, then you have nothing. They can do you anything they want. So every power, evil powers, demanding your worship, demanding your prayers, demanding your sacrifice to God, I command them to receive the blood of Jesus, the blood of Jesus Christ, and let them die in the name of Jesus. Yes? They are the powers. They know what you have. When you go to work, some wicked people, children of the devil, they get off the time that you need to worship. But you, because this power, they have seen that you are going to worship, they make sure that they have fixed you, they shift there, and you can't cancel, you have to work. That's how those powers are. Refuse them and break them. Refuse them, give them condition, make agreement. Say, whether I lose this money, I have refused, I'm not going to work certain time because I'm going to worship my father. If you do that, God will pay you and you are serious with it. If you lose that job, God will give you another one. You don't have to obey the voice of that devil and you leave the voice of God. That's how you can defeat it. When you are serious with God, God will help you. You cannot... We have people called Seventh-day Adventists. These people, they are Seventh-day Adventists. You know those people. If you are hire them, the first thing they will tell you is, Sabbath, I'm not working, whether you pay me or not. If they are in the hospital, they are in police force, they are wherever they are, a true Seventh-day Adventist will never work on Saturday. Any job, the first thing they go, they are looking for their day. If they will be working on that day, they will not take that job. They have to make agreement immediately when they are employed. If you see a Seventh-day Adventist working on Sabbath, they read it, the true Seventh-day Adventist working on Sabbath, then it's not a true Seventh-day Adventist. Even if it's a police force, even if it's in the doctor hospital, they will never work. That day, God will stop the sickness for them for that day. God will stop the criminal for them for that day. So God has favored them, and they are doing well. They are doing very well. They are known all over the globe. They are known that 7 days they don't work Saturday. But with us, children of God, that we worship on Sunday, Pentecost, we are not serious. We say you can work, you can do. And the enemy is roping you the very time the blessings of God is coming. You can work, yes. You don't take the whole day. Why can't you work in the morning or in the evening so that you can have the time to worship God? When you see the enemy is attacking your time of worshiping God, that is a great enemy. Therefore, I pray that God Almighty will destroy them in the name of Jesus. Like now, we have time to worship God. You are at work. And children of the devil are off, sitting home worshiping idols. That is a lie. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray that God will provide a way for you in the wilderness, in the desert. The Lord will provide a way in the desert, as the Bible says. Go and look at that scripture. The Lord Almighty, your Father, will provide your way in the name of Jesus. If you are a doctor, The Lord will heal that those patients that make you to work on Sunday. If you are working in a home, or wherever you are working on Sunday, the Lord will provide a way. There must be a shift. There must be a shift that you will be enjoyable. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, Lord, we thank you. Mercy of God, compassion of mercy of God, and the blood of Jesus Christ, roll away the anger of God from your life and family. In the mighty name of Jesus. Infirmity that swallowed wages, die in the name of Jesus. Wasters and emptiers assigned against you, I command them to die. Any member of your family marked for dead this year, this month, the month of August, receive deliverance by fire in Jesus' name. Every curses setting you in the opposite of divine destiny, I command them to be uprooted by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus, sword of judgment, released against your family, I command them to melt by fire in the name of Jesus Christ. Angers provoked by wasters of your family, stumble and fall by the blood of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Agreement with dark powers made by your ancestors to correct your star, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with dark powers made by your ancestors to correct your star, break by the blood of Jesus. Any agreement with dark powers against you, against your forefathers, any agreement with dark power made by ancestors against you, against your star, let them be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Agreement with dark power made by your ancestors to correct your glory, I command them to break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to correct your wonders, I command them to break in Jesus' name. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to correct your money, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to correct your money, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to divert your wealth, break in the name of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to turn away your progress, backfire in the name of Jesus. Agreement with dark powers made by your ancestors to turn your progress backward, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to waste your children, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to make you sorrowful, break in the name of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to bury your star, break in the name of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to scatter your marriage, break in the name of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to fundraise your destiny, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement made with the dark powers by your ancestors to control your life, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with the dark powers made by your ancestors to force you to link you into your programmer's idol and adultery, break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement with dark powers made by your ancestors to waste your effect, break by the blood of Jesus. Break by the blood of Jesus. Agreement dark powers made by your ancestors to regret your shining, break in the mighty name of Jesus. Agreement dark powers made by your ancestors to correct your host of your destiny, break in the name of Jesus. Break in the name of Jesus. In the full term this year, lay your hands upon your chest and your belly and oppose your anything that is opposing you in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, every step you take this year shall attract dominion favor in the name of Jesus. Every Asian serpent working against your destiny, business, family, and the land of Canada, the land of your place where you are living, the land of the land of Canada, the land of your blessing, where you are living right now. If it's Australia, if it is America, let them lose you and die by thunder in the name of Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you. I destroy every agreement of dark powers that is working against you. I destroy them in the name of Jesus. I come against every agreement with the dark powers. Every agreement with the dark powers, I am commanding them to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Every agreement with the dark crowd that is covering your crowd, I destroy them in the name of Jesus. Any agreement the enemy has made against you, we change it in the mighty name of Jesus. We turn it around to favor you in Jesus' name. You are overcomers. You are overcomers. You are overcomers. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. My God and my Father, I want to thank you, Jesus. I want to bless your name. I give you all the glory, God. Loving Father, I give you honor. I magnify your name. I bless you, God. I give you thanks, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. God, I acknowledge you. I thank you. I destroy every dark agreement in the mighty name of Jesus. As we are going to make agreement of Jesus Christ, as we are going to make agreement with God, agreement that will move us forward, every agreement of the devil, we destroy them. We are moving to make a new agreement of moving forward in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, my Father, I jump out every satanic agreement. I come to agreement of new beginning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, I thank you. Father, I bless you. I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you very much. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I want to thank you so much. Thank you for coming. God bless you, bless you. Have a wonderful Sunday and see you tomorrow midnight. We are starting tomorrow midnight. People are so much confused. We have said we have 4 midnights. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. We are coming back to midnight. Weekends, we don't have midnight. We have mornings. So if you are confused, you don't know the time, call me, I will help you. The time, it is on the website all the time. It is there so you can help yourself. Also, we have radio prayer. Is it called radio prayer? Prayer radio. We have radio program. And the number, you can call back. It's called prayer call back. This prayer, this number, you can always call back. And you can hear this message. They are all there. If you miss the prayer line, you miss the scope, you miss the prayer, the periscope, you miss things, but you can go on the radio and you can listen them later. We have a lot of media now. You can get this message on your bed, when you are driving. You just call the number, then you are good. Yes, treasure. Thank you, Felman. Thank you, thank you. So the number to reach to call back is 712-775-7089. This is the number, the same access code number is 595119. So the number to call back to resend the message of Prophetess Dr. Christine Ziggy. This is the number you can call. It is not prayer line, it is radio prayer call back. So when you call on your cell phone, this prayers, it is there on your cell phone. The number is 712-775-7089. Access code number is 595119. So the same code number is the same that you will call back. Thank you very much. I want to invite you to our barbecue, Niagara Falls. We will be going Niagara Falls, Niagara in the lake. We'll start 9 o'clock from here. We go there, we have the whole day. If you are from another country, from states, wherever you are, you want to come and join us, 20th of August, we will have our barbecue. So you are welcome. You are welcome, and I'm inviting you to come and join us. Thank you very much. God bless you. I love you so much. There's nothing I can do about it. Remember to call us. Remember to call our website. To go to call our website. And always remember to donate. Give donation. God will bless us. Watch your donation. When you give, every time you give to our ministry, what is happening? Are you flowing? Is there any blessings? That's what I want you to watch. If you are giving our ministry and nothing is happening, don't give. That's what I want to tell you. But if you are giving and you see the blessings is there flowing, give. People, I'm telling you, the Bible does not lie. The Bible says God will rebuke the devourer. If you are church where you are giving, the devourer has not been rebuked. You better look for the church where the devourer will be rebuked. Don't be deceived. God is not a mockery. God is a God who does not change and is a true God and has blessed his people. I thank you so much. Remember to call me. Our number is 647-608-5207. Or you can reach me 905-487-7196. Thank you very much. Thank you for the half. Thank you. Thank you. See you tomorrow midnight. Monday midnight. 12 midnight. 12 midnight. Please. That's when we come on again. Prayer line will be on. And if you want to come on prayer line, you are welcome. If you want to come on Periscope, you are welcome. Thank you so much. God bless you. I love you so much. And there is nothing I can do about it. Bye.